In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use an imported SVG collection meshes as a particle object. Let's import an SVG file. If you don't have this feature in the menu, please activate an SVG import add-on. I'll select and scale the SVG objects. What would be the best way to extrude the objects without losing its original material? If we join all objects while in the curve mode, we'll immediately lose unique materials. If we don't join them, we can't extrude them at the same time. Select all SVG objects, and right-click them to convert them to meshes. In edit mode, type E to extrude. In edit mode, type 3 to face select. A to select all, and P to separate by loose parts. Let's move the origins to the geometry. Now we can type M to put them into a new collection. Let's create a ground plane and add a set of hair particles. This time, we must pick collection instead of object as the particle mesh. We need to rotate the objects to belly up on the surface. In edit mode, change to individual origins. Type A to select all, type R twice, and type 90 to rotate them 90 degrees. I'll increase the size of the particles, rotate them in normal, and increase the emission number. Let's make the instance real, and put them to a new collection. Let's make sure the meshes on the screen are the only objects we can select. The idea is to randomly select them 25% each time, and move the randomly selected objects up or down. I'll add a metallic material to the plane mesh, and use sky texture as the environment light. I'll use 16 samples to save time. Please use at least 128 samples to get the best looking result. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.